I'm joined by APD head coach and co-founder Harry Watlin. Thank you for joining us on APD TV. Are you looking forward to your session today, Harry?
Yeah, I am. Really looking forward to it. Got a good group of players in today. Just really excited. Really excited for how it's going to go.
Great stuff. What are we expecting to see from your session today?
I'm working on a 1v1 domination drill, but I'm also going to incorporate it and build it up into a 2v2, also into a small-sided game, so we've got the full picture for the players to see and practice in, so it replicates the game at the end.
Oh, great stuff. What is your expectation from the players today?
Just give everything they can. It's a hot day, so I'm not going to demand too much of them. I'll try my best to get them going, and then we'll see how they go from there.
Great stuff. Thank you very much for joining us, and good luck, Harry.
Thanks a lot. Cheers. Okay. Hey, have you got me? Why? Right, boys, get a little bit more on the tops, so I'm not going to demand too much of you. And today, we're working on a little audit, up and up and up and up and up, so it looks like a game at the end. So what we learn, we can incorporate into the game. Is that okay? Yeah, brilliant. Now what I would like my two goalkeepers, one in that goal, one in that goal, quick as you can. And then we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. If you go and get green bibs on for me over there. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Go and get pink bibs on for me, quick as you can. Pop that in your goal team. Hit your goal, Benedict. Good lad. Right, okay. Now, to start off with, what I would like is I'd like my pink players, so Callum, if you could go over there without your ball, stand behind Benedict's goal, without your ball, behind Benedict's goal, without your ball, behind the mannequins, Zion, behind the mannequins for me, well done, brilliant, you two, behind that goal, without your balls, without your footballs, Danny Potter, in between these two, without your footballs, brilliant, the rest of you, get yourselves into the diamond in the middle, with a football, quickly as you can. Dan, if you move that football bag out of the way, sir, just so there's a bit of room. If you give a pink one, that'd be great. Okay, now, how is it going to work to start off with? We're going to go one versus one on a 4-point attack. So four different points. So Georgie Belcher, you're going to defend first there, Zion. You will drop off and rest, if that's okay. And then over there, Harry. You're gonna defend first. Eugene, you'll rest. Danny, you'll have a turn, you'll rest Jed. And then we'll make something over there as well. Now how it will work is, Archie, for me demonstration, if you wouldn't mind just driving into that area with your ball, Harry, come and engage me in 1v1. Brilliant, now relax. Now Archie's chosen that side. Only four of you can go at once. Now that's important. Four will rest and four will roll. Really important to remember that. You might choose to go this way. You might choose to go that way and take Carter that way. Now, these are the four goals. Two goals here, we're going against the keeper and the defender, so it's realistic to a game. This side, we're going 1v1 and you've got a choice. So you're going to go against Danny or Jed, you can go into two small goals, that's fine. This side, against George Belcher, you're trying to get it past the line. Bit of speed, bit of skill, bit of change of direction. Does that make sense? Defenders, you switch every time, and attackers, on your way back, have a little think to where you want to go next. So I don't need to get in here, stop looking, thinking while you're moving. Is that okay? Right, get yourself ready. You're going first there, Carl first there, Jack first there, Carl first there. Ready? First group, play! Off you go! Well played. Good, you can go as soon as your pal's finished. As soon as he's gone, keep it rolling. If there's anything spare, take it. Good. Good finish, Alfie. Good try. And just relax there. Brilliant. Now, defenders, if you manage to pinch it back, which Daniel Potter's done here, don't when you're smashing it away, because you've worked ever so hard to win the ball. And you've got a big circle in the middle. Drive with your ball, get it inside that circle, you get yourself a point. Alright? Can you win it? You leave it behind you with a bit of speed and get into there. Are we ready? Off you go, play! Great
Oh, Benedict, that's not bad. It's not bad at all. Good help. Love that, Alfie. Brilliant stop. Okay. On your way back, you're thinking. Thinking on your way back. Heads up. You know what your shoes look like. Look at your trainers. Eyes up. Scanning the pitch. Well done. Brilliant.
Guys, have you gone through this?
Hey, good start. Good. Well done. Yeah, go on then, Jack. Off you go. Good. Well played. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. Oh! Don't worry, John. It's all right. And time. Rest there. Brilliant. Now, Green, can you change over to Pink for me so they get a feel of the practice? So, Green, just pair off at the top. Pink's collect the footballs in. Benedict, do me a favour for me. Go and get those two. Brilliant. Okay, now, Pink, before we get the line, I want you to think about this. How am I going to move him? Now, it's a different target on each side, so you might have to do something different every time. Maybe speed, maybe skill, maybe a combination, maybe here. You might just have to be a bit more clever than you make. Are we ready? Come on in, play, off you go. Well done, Benedict. Control your centre half in front of you. Come on, this is realistic. Communication from you. Love that, Eugene. That's brilliant. And just rest there. Stand still. Okay. Now, this is where you've got to be a little bit of a magician, Jed, because you can't touch him. You cannot touch him, but you've got to move him. All right? So you might have to do one of three things. Now, I can move him with a shift of balance. I can move him with a change of speed. What I must do, I must try to tease him. Where he thinks he can pinch the ball, but I quickly nick it away and I'm off. You tease him into that tackle, and then as he tries to pinch, that's when you explode away and you need that little change in direction. Now, you may be coming up against Callum, someone that's quicker than you. That happens. So you might have to meet him with two things. You might have to meet him once, and he catches you, but the second time, he can't change quick enough. Is that okay? I want you to make me say, well, gentlemen, off you go, play. How many of my defenders can win that ball back and score me a goal? Archie's going to do it. Well done, sir. Brilliant. Good. Eyes up, Harry. Well played. Really good. Yes, Callum, I love it. Pen hasn't given it, though. Go on in, carry on. Brilliant, great work, great stuff. Last couple. Come on in, go somewhere where you haven't gone before, somewhere different. Oh, Danny Potter, that is absolutely magic. So, Ed, try that again, it'll work, keep going, hold that. And time, that's it, hold up, jump yourselves into me. Everybody into the line in the middle. Keep them as well. It's important for you because you're in control of the amazing front. Okay, right. Right, now we're going to go for another couple of minutes and we're going to go and have a drink. Okay? Now, so far, outstanding.
Yep, there is.
A couple of things I want to think about. Just a couple of things. I want you to try and be excited. Right, so I want you to imagine you've got one of these in your hand. You're not going to share it with anyone. It's your time. You're a singer. Imagine you're a singer. Your time to shine and show what you can. So when you've got that ball, I want you to try and do something outrageous. Because if it comes off, how are you going to feel afterwards? If you lose it, you lose it. Doesn't matter. You can go and win it back, George, can't you? All right? But if you picked it, wow, goal scoring opportunity straight away. Use your imagination. We'll keep the pinks in the middle for the meantime. Let's go. Now, can the greens change where they're defending so they're defending something different? Okay. Brilliant. We need somewhere over there, please, mate. On the end zone. Okay, pinks. Have a little dribble inside your diamond. Anywhere you like. And then when you feel the time is right to go, first man to each post. Run it, play. Good, if you think it's a hit, don't worry. Love that. That's
exactly what I'm talking about. Good boy, brilliant man. Hey, good stuff, well done. Execute the finish early. Good boy. Brilliant, huge, love that. Can I go slow? Slow him down, then quick and get out of there. There it is, George, love that. How do we score, mate? Can we kick it away? Can we be positive? Drive up the pitch a bit. Brilliant. There it is. And time. Relax there. Quick and pinch. Swap yourself over for me. Very good start. Okay. We need someone over there. Hey, can you go over there for me? Good lad. Walk there. Okay, now what's going to happen is you two are going to work as a pair. Okay? You're going to work as a pair together. I'm actually going to progress it so that they still stay on their own. I want to make it harder for them. You've got to beat two players. Just deal with it. All right? If anything, be more positive. All right? So I'm going to nip you in, see how you get on. One of you go really high if you want to try a pinch. Or you can both defend either to you. It's up to you. We're going to go live in 10 seconds. You might have a little chat down with Eugene about your tactics and how to approach it. Reed, you're going for the robot. Okay? Ready? Play! Off you go! Oh, well done, Jack. Brilliant, Jack. Top man. Well played. Well played. Good. Well done, Dan. Hey, is that a goal? Hey, come in with some more. Come in. Come back. Good. Magic remains. How's that right foot, maybe? Good calm, love your shoulders, love your shoulders. Hey, well played. Good stuff, good stuff. Good effort. Last minute. Nice ball, keep going for me. Good effort so well. Well played. I'll stay on the feet, how you might pinch it back. Good. And relax there. Okay, boys, go and grab yourselves a drink and then come back. So have a minute to rest and relax. Grab yourself some water. Boys, boys, that white three there, the white three. Got lots of water in it, go and help yourself. Big white box there.
Thank you.
Drink it all, Benedict. Right, okay, jump yourselves over. Who's in my first 10 over to me? Who's going to be in the first 10? Come on then. Well done. Alfie Eric, do not be last. Come on. Goalkeepers change ends for me. Goalies change ends. Okay, who is just attacking? Right, are you going to switch over? So switch over as quick as you can. Let's go. Last little bit. Good. You're alright. Okay. Greens, you're going to defend as a pair again. Pinks, you go out by yourself. What we've spoken about, imagination, be creative. Also be really, really positive. Be aggressive with your skill. I'm going to beat you. Let's go, play! Superb sound, brilliant. Right, disguising your shoulders and hips. Marvellous work for you. Good. Go on then, try it then, try it. Danny Potter, show me two different speeds when you're dribbling now. Good, Georgie Bells, come in. Quick.
Keep going.
Yeah, pass up. Right, okay. Oh, he's quick. He's scoring. He's scoring. He's scoring. All right, go on, here you go. Go play. Good boy, love it. How many goals are there? Look at that. Oh, that would have been a clap from the stand, George. That is outrageous. Really good feet. Really good. Can you take advantage of them? Not concentrate. Brilliant. And time. Rest there. Right, last little pick team. You're now going to become a pair as well. Of eight now. Let's throw some things out there. How can we beat our two players? Right, combinations aren't yet. Welsh. Brilliant. 1-2s, yeah? Yeah. Now, I'm going to ask you a question. Me and George are going together. Yes, George. Now, if I use him, do I have to give him the ball? Wait. I can send you that way by going for him. There's something like that. No problem. He's run. He's run. Again, be a magician. Move me, so we won't go around there. He won't follow you, and then I'm in. 1v1, you're in trouble. Does that make sense? Right, go on and give it a go. Pair yourselves up. Play, off you go. What a run that is, Jed. Good. Good. Hard luck, hard luck. The intention was there, it's the main thing. Good boy. Okay, right, so how can you control now these two players like the two centre-backs? Good. Keep playing, a minute to go. Well done, Harry. Harry, collect your ball and take it back. Warning call, right. Good, Victor. Yes, Victor, and the left foot. What to say, keep up. And time. Last switch. Green's in, pinks out. Don't be lost. Good, 30 seconds to go. Can you score one more goal? Keep working up. Well played, Jude. Hey, why not ask? Why not? You scored in the big goal, I think. No, miss that one as well. Try. Good, mate. Now he's worried because he doesn't know what he's going to do. Yeah, and time. Okay, boys. Everybody needs their own football. Everybody, apart from the Cats. Goalkeepers, you don't need a ball. Everybody else does. Who's short? Is it the green? A short? Yes, H. Got a green on, son. Didn't tell you in there. Now, Dick, you was gelling your hair, weren't you? Come on, let's go. Okie dokie. Now this time, we're actually going to just play this way. Okay? Now, what I'm going to ask you to do is greens, you're going to go first. So what I would like is I'd like you two to go over to the blue cone on the far side over there, please. Quick as you can, you ball. You two, get yourself on the pink cone over there. Brilliant. You two on the blue, and you two get yourself on the white cone. Brilliant. Okay. You two, get yourself on the white cone there by the mannequin. You two, I know you like going together. Pink cone over there. You two, yellow cone, and you two on the blue cone form. Brilliant. Goalkeepers, how are we feeling? All right? Yeah, are you sure? Brilliant. Okay. Now, how this is going to work, it's a reaction game. It's a reaction game. Now, goalkeepers, it might be a little bit difficult for you to start off with because you are going to face two shots consecutively. What will happen is, when I say play, the team here by the goals will go first. Hotch, Remain, Harry, and Alfie, you'll dribble into the star in the middle. Out, dribble in. You're going to zigzag. You're going to go inside and outside, Alfie, and you're going to finish in that goal. And just relax. Now, what cone did Alfie start playing on? The blue cone. And when I say play to the second group, Alf's got to then react. Spin round. Where's the other blue cone, Alf? Brilliant. Jed, you're going to come at Alfie and score this way, and that's a 1v1. We're going to have four of them going on at the same time, so it's going to be chaos. It'll be madness. No to traffic. Get your head up and just work through it. You're all going to go at the same time. When I say group two play, Danny Potter, you and Jed are both going to attack that goal. Dan, you're going to be attacking who? Top man, well done. Harry, who are you defending against? Brilliant. Everyone happy with that? Spot on. Yeah, Ralph, go back. Restart. Let's see how it looks. Now, keepers, like I say, be mindful that there's two coming at you at the same time. You might jump in on the second one. Ready? Green team, play. Lion, you're a pink. Good. Pinks, off you go, play. Ball in, react. Where's your mate? Eyes up, Arch. Good, good. Hey, Harry, you've done ever so well. Done ever so well. Well played. Jack, who man's that over there? It might be yours. Might be yours. Good block and relax. Next green, off you go. Green, play. Good. Ah, oh, lovely remain. Brilliant. Yes, big team, off you go. Go on, Callum. Go on, Callum. Don't let it catch up. Get the old side of him, Carlo. Good. Brilliant. Yeah, brilliant. And relax. Okay. So now we've got an idea. Yeah? Now we've got an idea. We might be mindful of where we release our first shot. Because what we've got to do once we've had our first shot? We've got to react and recover, haven't we? So replicating the game, we've had a shot. Keeper might have caught it, well, for a counter-attack or a recount the other way. Right, now I've got to really work hard for my team, Harry Brook, and get this side of the player, goal side of him, and help my goalkeeper out. So from the green team, I'm looking for a real sharp reaction from you. Need to run a little bit. We'll see how we go. Greens, off you go, play. Good. And pink play. Got it. Yes, Art, can we engage with him? Brilliant. Well done. That's better this side. Good. Excellent. And we've had no goals. So my defenders, that's outstanding from the green. Well played. Took it on ball. Gonna go one more time. Green play. Good. Keep your eyes up. Brilliant, Remain. Where's your shot going? Good, react. Yes, Pink, play. You want to get goal side on him. Hey, Carl, that's great energy. Where are you going to score, Carl? Where are you going to score? Good boy. Brilliant. And relax there. Superb. Okay. Greens and pinks. I want you to swap jobs. So, Harry, you'll just swap codes. You'll stay on the pink. In your group, and Danny Potter's group, and you change over. So, can you do that now for me, please? Callum, kick off as well. Zion, you might need a ball. Excellent, okay. Really good. Now in this part here, and I'm speaking specifically now to the green team on the outside. Think about the position of your defender. He may be behind you. If he's behind you, you may have to use one attribute that you've got. If he manages to get in front of you, he's off balance, it'll be something different. If he manages to get this side of you, and he's balanced, then again, we've got to be a magician, Harry Brook. We've got to pull something out of the hat, make this lot over here go, wow, seriously, okay? Pinks, I need loads of energy, loads of enthusiasm to win the ball back, because if you do win it off the green and you put it in the goal, it's now worth 10. Are we ready, Pink Team? Pink Team, off you go. Wait. Good, get back offside. Yes, Green, tonight. Go on, George Belsham. Go on, George. Go on, George. Get something on it for me. Hey, Benedict, top save, son. Top save. Belch, he's missed that because you were behind him breathing heavily. And he heard you and you put him off. So your effort does not go unnoticed. Well done. Let's go, play. Brilliant. And relax, good. Get yourself back into position. Benedict, can I have two footballs, please, sir? Thank you. Okay, boys, one more progression to this. Now, how it's going to work now is after I've said to the green team that they come in and play, I'm going to fire this ball here. And you're going to play 4v4 in the middle. So now it looks like a game. So you keep your ball out, because you're going to have your dribble. And once you've had your shot, I'll play in. Now, Green, you will score against Benedict on the big game. So the big game will always come from me here. Pinks, where are you scoring? Just so we're clear, Daniel, glad you're with me. George, well done. Need to wake up over there. So it's the same practice, but there's a third step. The third step is the game, the golden goal. Is everyone happy with that? Marvellous. Are we ready to go, Pinks? Off you go. Goal side, Victor. Goal side of him. Yeah, play! Well done, George. Excellent reaction. Look at that. Zion, I think you can get there, son. Good. Good. Yes, go on then, here we go, line and play up. 4v4, where's your mates? Harry and Kellen, you're playing in the game. There we are. Good try. Jack, are you available to recycle it? Might not need you. Make sure you're available, please. Keep going, H. We're going to go 10 seconds, otherwise we're turning the channel over. Come on. Yeah, it's not a bad ball. Hey, Archie, I like your angle, son. Brilliant. You've got the ball as well. Top man. Good. How good's that keeper? Go on in. 5, 4, and time. Relax there. Brilliant. Do we understand that? Yes, you stay on the pitch for all 3 chances. I've got another ball here. Well played. Are we ready? Eugene, you ready? Go on in, play! Line, you're live, mate. Gonna have a drink after this, go, don't tap. Good. Go on in, get yourself goal side. Greens, play! Get your scorecard. Jed, I love your enthusiasm. Yep, big game, here we go. Who's on it first? Not you, Cal. There we are, 4v4, marvellous. Oh, big save, big save. Play off. Khan, you may be a wee bit offside. Yep, one more ball. Yes, Jim. Hang on, hang on. Hey, it's clever. That's very clever. Eyes up. Go see your feet? Can he see your feet? Good, Huge. End product. That's not bad. And relax. Boys, well done. Get yourselves another quick drink. You can have 2 minutes rest. Good stuff. Very good. Okay, boys, walk over with your drinks. You can bring your drinks over. A Ronaldo chop, that's my one, because I want to see if you can do it. We're working on that today. Ronaldo chop, a volley, score from a volley, a Gerrard, which bit Gerrard is? A rainbow flick. Who fancies yourself for that, yeah? Good, I like your style. Good, good. I'm pleased that you put your hair up, because I didn't really want to demonstrate that one. Now, if you score one of those goals, you come over, your noughts and your crosses, and you pop your noughts or your cross in there, and you need to communicate to your teammates what goals you need in order to get yourself a line. So either a straight one, horizontal, or a diagonal. Are there any questions with that? Okay. If you do a 1-2, a rainbow flick, and then volley it, yes. Seriously, I don't think we'll be able to do it, but take it as a challenge. Right, everybody needs to go and collect a ball each and bring it back into me and we'll start the game. We have about 15 minutes, if that. Yes, you do. Well, we need a ball. No, we're just using the two big goals. Bring them in. And then pink, you're going to go down this end, down here, and green, you're going to go down that end. Yes. Whatever one you like. Roll the balls in. Victor, that's not helping anybody, because I've got to run and get there, but I'm really slow. Okay, set yourself up. First team ready to play, we'll get the ball. Pink, you've decided to go down this end. Green's up that side. Okay, goalkeepers. Goalkeepers, if I shout change ends, you need to run as fast as you can into the other goal. As fast as you can. That gives us an opportunity to maybe try and lob you. Are we ready? Is everyone switched on? So are you ready? You want to play? Yeah, we'll have a new one here. Yep. Good try. Yeah, go on in, play. Oh, might have a little counter attack there, Romain, if you can get there. Yes, you can. Well, play some. Play up. Good lad. What type of goal are we going to go for, gents? Go on in. Ooh, great awareness, Carl. Who's brave enough to get on that ball? Brilliant, mate. Yeah, that's great football. The next goal is worth two, gentlemen. Next person to score in the goal is worth two for their team. Good. Love that. Good job. Jen, you've inverted your brother a little bit earlier. Well, I can see, get off the back of his shirt, you're in. Yes, Eugene, great enthusiasm to win it back, young man. Good boy. Yeah, play, here we go. Love that, Arch, love that. Yes. Off the pitch, go on then, who's moving for me? Card you are, and you're free. What type of goal? Yeah. There he is. Good try. Yes, go on then. This side. Yeah, flash. Loads of time. What's a ball, sir? Now are you going to stand there and admire it, or are you going to go and support it? Top football. Yes, go on then. We've got counter attack here. Two versus one. Count if you break your neck. 3v1. 3. Magic. Georgie Belcher. It's the best thing I've seen all day. Honestly, top man. We've got 4 minutes green and you're 1-0 down. Might have to force it a little bit. Change your start.
Putting the lock on the gate now.
Yep, call in. Play. Get out. Yeah, go on then. Well played, George. Great protection. What type of goal do you need to win? Ah, good. Good. For the coaches in the audience, they're trying to set up a headed effort. Well done, in your cup, quick as you can. Just have a little seat down there. Okay, you can have a drink in 1 minute, well done. Right. Just some little things that you've taken away from that, as a player, or as a person, maybe you might think, you know what, I've got a bit braver about this. What have you taken from that, and what's the suggestion? Yes, sir. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with shooting from long range, is there? Yeah, be creative on the ball. And you, Mr. over there, find the centre back. You can play my 5 sides here, right? I can't believe it. Yeah? Yeah? Get it right, cross it in the box, half the defender. Express yourself, you did that, mate. Not be afraid to try nothing. When you're 35 and you're playing maybe in a massive game of football where if you make a mistake you really balance then okay. When you're playing here on a bit of grass, do whatever you like. Yeah? You've got to force you to try right, I think, doesn't it? Yeah? Brilliant. Last one. Brilliant. Okay, listen, you've worked ever so hard. You're going to go over to them people over there, get yourself a big round of applause, and then get yourself a drink. Well done.
Sometimes I did that on purpose because sometimes you'll do a session and you just have mannequins in the middle. And I worked with a guy I've had some really good teaching. Mike's it, I don't know where Mike is, but Mike Bill's one of them. But I also worked with a guy called Bob Osborne at Chelsea. And he used to just say to me sometimes, just leave it. And for the players, visually, it's something else. It's another obstacle they've got to overcome. So if you've just nicked it past somebody, and then you've got to nick it past the cone. For me, it represents something like when I used to play football outside my house or on the street, you would have to dodge curbs and it just gives you probably a natural sense of the dribbler. So by all means, you could use flats, but I've just used the Superdomes today.
And see, do you use like the same principles as like John Henderson helped with Bristol City? Sorry, Mr. Rose, he does a lot of kiosk stuff, you copy it.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
I I think, do you know what? I think I've been coaching for a fair while. I'm 26 now. I've been coaching a fair while. I started really young. I started at 15. I think the best coaches that I've watched, and I'm not putting myself in this bracket, the best coaches that I've watched that have got the ability to put different hats on. They've got the ability to walk in a changing room full of six-year-olds and get them going. But then again, they've got the ability to go, right, I've got a group of scholars or 21s. And I need to change it. I need to change up. I need to be a little bit more stern. I need to be a little bit more real. It's unbelievable. Chris said at the beginning about personality. Could not agree more. And I thought you were great, by the way, Chris, but you spoke really well. But I would say, yes, today I was showcasing what I've done for probably the first 5 years of my coaching career, working with the little ones. Now I work with the 12s at Millwall, and I work with a group of 18 scholars at APD, and I do some day release stuff in Millwall as well. So, to answer your question, I'd say horses for courses, if I may. Yeah. Brilliant. Any others? Nope. Yeah. What age do I want to develop both feet? Good question, Mommy. I think it depends. I think the best player in the world at the moment is left foot dominant. And he's got an unbelievable left foot, he's outstanding. His right foot is okay, it's better than mine, don't get me wrong, but his right foot is okay. But he is outstanding with his left foot. I'm a little bit mixed up with that one, because I do think at the young ages, you've got to improve their technical ability and get them well balanced for both sides. But I do think there comes a time where we've got to look at a player individually and go, right, he's not going to be an all-rounder, but he's going to be outstanding at that one key attribute or those two key attributes. Like you might have a wide player who's just an unbelievable crosser of the ball. David Beckham couldn't beat anybody 1v1, but could deliver a ball. If you put a pound coin 35 yards away from him, he'd hit it 9 times out of 10. And I think that we look at that later on down the line and we say, right, he's probably going to be very, very good at this. So let's help him with his weaknesses, but let's make him top, top, top draw with his strengths. All right?
Harry, why did you use different targets for the players to score?
Mainly because I think sometimes what you can get lost in is you can get lost with... You get a lot of boys that grow at different rates. So your athletes, they might be very, very, very good at attacking one type of goal. I think if you looked out there was a little boy, I don't know if you see George Belsham, a little lad. Unbelievable football player. He plays for me at Millwall, he's an under 12. We have to protect him a little bit, but with drills like that, it complements him, because it's not just a case of, right, run past an end zone as fast as you can. For him, it's right, you've got two goals, and so now you've got the opportunity to be an artist and go one way and then go the other and show us what you can do. And I think that gives him a platform. If you layer your session and you build them up confidence-wise from there, you get to the game like we did at the end. And he went to me at the end, he went, I just really wanted to do a rainbow flick. Brilliant, son, that's good. And I think when you're building them up like that, that's probably the reason why, Jay, I went with the multi goal system, if you like.
Why are 1v1 so important in today's game?
Okay, good question. Blimey. I think, right, if we break down the 11-a-side game, and this is just the way I look at it, some people look at it as units, I look at it as duels, individual duels. So, for example, if you've got a fullback, you're having a constant duel with a wide player. Nowadays, you might be having a duel with maybe a 10 or a 10 and a half. Some wide players like to play inside that little half space. Centre-half's got to be good 1v1. A lot of centre-halves in modern-day football don't have to be good 1v1, because a lot of teams play 4-3-3 with two sort of wideys, if you like, and they've only got to look after one centre-forward. So the value in developing these boys so that they can do this bit, but then also do this bit, I think is key, because when it comes to that end product, if you like, that end line, are they physically robust enough to play at the top level? Are they capable of dominating those 1v1 scenarios, whether it be short and sharp, whether it be long distance? Are they mentally capable of doing it as well? And that's another thing, it's a mental side, looking at someone and going, can I beat you 1v1? Now can I beat you 1v1 playing in front of 100 people? Now can I do it playing at Old Trafford? So it's a cycle that you've got to build and build and build. So for me, the little ones, 1v1 domination is a real key element of their development. Well done.
Anyone else got any more questions, Barry?
That's right, I just wanted to see the 1v1 kind of thing that's done in Scotland, and maybe in England too. But after, like, you do like 1v1s on the younger kids, and then 12 up to 14 starts with 2v1s, and then it comes to phase of plays, and we don't see a lot of, you see the guys where we're kind of going into, you know, that kind of age, or kind of, you know, like, how do you kind of, how do you get out coached 1v1s, because you've seen even like the
it boils down to styles, it boils down to ethos and philosophy. Sorry to keep bringing you up, Mick, but when I went up to Liverpool just to watch him, just to study, and met some brilliant people up there, they're really big on it. Even at Mick's age group, 21s, they're really big on it. They're talking about the Zidanes and people like this, they're really big on it, because again, it goes back to those duels. And when you look at the big games in football, and we sit there and watch, and we're gonna sit down and watch Atletico Madrid versus Real Madrid, and we're gonna probably be talking about one individual that changes that game. And in a 1v1 situation, you've got Simeone that set a team up there. I've never seen anything like it. I think he's a throwback, and it's brilliant. Everyone runs through brick walls for him, but he still needs Griezmann to do it. He needs him to do it. Or he needs Torres to pop up and do it. Or he needs his centre-half. His name escaped me. His centre-half is unbelievable. He needs him to make that big tackle. Top, top player. So, again, I would say it boils down to philosophy. Some clubs will say, right, you are now part of that back four. So just be mates with him. Stay connected to him. Drop off when he attacks it. Attack it if he drops off, and that's it. But horses for courses again. Sorry to sit on the fence. Lim?
Yeah. Where are your progressions today as drills?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, definitely. What I wanted to do today is I wanted to try and show you, imagine if you press fast forward on the session and just got the kind of best bits. But yeah, I'm definitely working on it a little bit longer. I think the thing is, when I first started coaching, what I wanted to do for my people that was in charge of me, I wanted to show them how many sessions I could do and what I could come up with and how imaginative I was. But then I would think back to when I was playing. And it took me a little while to get used to each practice. And Chris touched on earlier, learning styles. There's so many different learning styles, there's so many different teaching styles. So for a player, he needs a little bit longer. And you say, right, you're changing the practice after 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Bloody hell, he's only just figured it out. And he didn't look great because he was trying to understand what you were thinking about, rather than, actually, do you know what? There's a goal at that end of the pitch, and there's a goal at that end of the pitch. Scoring that one, don't concede in that one. So I think I have been guilty over the years massively of overcomplicating my work. But today was, yeah, it was like a little best bit snippet of kind of what a session would look like, layered, build them up. But like you say, it would change. Sometimes you might just go whole part whole. You might start with a game and then move into a phase to get your topic out and then go back into a game again. And that's the kind of style I'll maybe go with my 12s. It's a tough age group, 12s, because you're teaching them to play 11-a-side football. First time they've ever played it. You're asking a lad to play it as part of a back four, and he goes, well, he's been telling me for 3 years to just get it and beat someone. So you would probably go with a different style there, whole part, whole, like I say. If we was working on pressing, I would go, right, there's a game. Team one, go and win it as many times as you can in that third. Team two, just play. 20 minutes. Brilliant, well done. You won it 8 times in their third. How many did you score? No. Okay, right. Let's have a go at my practice. Do my practice for maybe another 20 minutes. Now let's go back to the game. Let's compare the two games. How many times you win it now? We won it 12 and we scored twice. Brilliant. So your press is more effective. You're steering the opposition where you want it to go. And you're penetrating and you're scoring. So in answer to your question, yes. Any others? Yeah.
When you do your opponent like APD on a Monday,
yeah.
Two of my boys come down. I manage an under 17 at the moment.
Yeah.
And as you say, you do like 8-minute rotation.
Yeah.
How, that's obviously very good, and as you say, at the end of that, they're just getting it.
Yeah.
How long do you think you're strapped for
Yeah.
To fully understand.
That's a good question. With the APD session, we work on a rotation, like James said earlier, and I'll sit down with my tactics board and I'll design the sessions, and these boys will tell you, write them out, send them out to everybody, and we go. And what I try and make sure I do is make it simple, but make it so the player always has a choice. Because the age we're working with, they need to have a choice. So.
It's difficult to obviously year one, we'll have to.
Yeah. Yeah. But then I'll put the onus on these guys to go, right, okay, like I said a minute ago, put a different hat on. He's five. Teach him, allow him to play, just guide him so he discovers it a little bit. Right, he's 12, got an attitude problem, just got his first girlfriend, goes down the barbers, gets his own haircut, he's flash. Right, change the tune. That's what you've got to do. So I'd say, with the APD sessions, we strip it back. It looks good on the eye still, but we strip it back. And it's more about we facilitate the game rather than deliver a drill.
Yeah.
Does that make sense? Give you the ball, drive and score in there, show me a trick. Nice and simple and lower it in. Thanks very much for your time, everyone.
This is APD TV. I'm joined by APD co-founder and head coach, Harry Watlin. How was your session today, Harry?
No, it was good. Very, very hot outside. They gave me everything. I did a 1v1 domination drill. And the boys were unbelievable. It was really good. Had some fun with the sound at the start. I ended up holding the microphone, which was an interesting challenge because I couldn't demo. But again, it was a real good experience.
Great stuff. What are your thoughts on the event as a whole so far?
It's gone really well. Got to take my hat off to everybody that's sort of worked for us here. Sound guys, all the tech guys have been brilliant. James hosting it really well. Chris Powell was outstanding. Couldn't get him off the stage. He was really, really good. So yeah, excellent.
If you could take one experience away from today, what would it be?
I've coached first, so I've still got three real top guys to follow me, so I'm hoping to learn lots from them. So I'll probably be able to answer that better after the event.
Brilliant. Any final thoughts before we leave you?
No, just obviously humbled to be amongst some top guys, and I'm really looking forward to the rest of the day.
Brilliant. Thanks very much for your time, Harry.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.